Hi, welcome to this video. In this video, I'm going to demonstrate the YALPIC One board, which is an Arduino-like solution, but for the PIC microcontroller. So what will be shown in this video? First, what is YALPIC One? Then the schematic diagram of this YALPIC One board. Then a picture of the board once it is assembled, how it works, which commands the board uses, and then something about the Intelhex file format, which is being used to program the board. Then I will give a demonstration of two applications, and at the end of this video you can find some more information. So, what is YALPIC One? It's an Arduino Uno-like board, but it uses a PIC microcontroller. As you know, the Arduino uses the Atmel microcontroller. It can be used for developing and testing YALP programs, but you don't need a separate PIC programmer like a PIC-IT2 or a PIC-IT3. And the board connections are the same as Arduino Uno, and this makes it possible to put an Arduino shield on top of the board. The YALPIC One uses a PIC16F18857 as a microcontroller to run your applications. This is a full-featured PIC microcontroller. It has 56 kilobytes of flash memory, 256 bytes of EEPROM, 4K bytes of SRAM, and many peripherals like a UART, SPI, I2C, 6 timers, pulse width modulators, ADC, and a digital to analog converters, and much more. In this demo, this video, I call this the application PIC. But on the board, there is another smaller PIC, the 16F1455. And it's used to control the USB interface. But this microcontroller will program the application PIC. So for now, we call this the control PIC. And this is what the board looks like. On the left, you see the application PIC, and on the right, the control PIC. And the control PIC interfaces with the USB and is used to program the application PIC. The serial interface of the application PIC goes to the connectors, but it's also connected to the control PIC. So this makes it possible to send information from the application PIC through the control PIC to the USB and back. There are two voltage regulators on the board, one for 5 volt and one for 3.3 volt. And there are some LEDs on the board. The red one is used to indicate power. A yellow one is connected to pin A0 of the application PIC and can be used for testing purposes. And there's another LED which indicates when the board is being programmed. And as already mentioned, the connectors on the board are the same as for Arduino Uno. And this is what the board looks like. As you can see, there are no surface mount devices because I'm not very good at soldering those. And here you can see the three LEDs. There's a small design flaw in this board, and this is the voltage regulators here at the bottom. When you put an Arduino shield on top of them, they're a little bit in the way, so you have them bend them a little bit back in order to put the shield on the board. The board can be powered by USB or by an external adapter. So how does it work? The application is just a blank PIC that's not programmed and it doesn't contain any bootloader. And the control PIC contains a YALP program, which handles the communication with the USB. It can erase the application PIC before programming. Of course, it can program the application PIC. And it can act as a serial interface between the application PIC and the USB, and so sending data between the application PIC and your PC. So the application PIC can be erased and programmed. Once you've entered the program command, you have to provide this Intel hex file. I will explain a little bit later what this is, so that the application PIC can be programmed. And since the program can be quite large, the control PIC can never hold the whole application. So what it will do, it will program the application PIC one line at a time from the Intel hex file. So, which commands are used by the YALPIC One board? Each command starts with an exclamation mark. And this is the list of commands. You can check if the board is alive. You can perform a blank check of the EEPROM and the flash. You can enable and disable the debug mode. You can erase EEPROM and flash independently. Of course, you can program the application, but once you've given the program command, you have to provide the int.hex file, which is the file that contains the program. You can reset the application pic, and you can activate the terminal mode, which means that the data from the application pic is passed on to the USB interface. And you can verify if the program in the pic is correct, and also in this case, you have to provide the int.hex file. So what is this int.hex file? It's a file format that conveys binary information in ASCII text form, and it's commonly used for programming microcontrollers. And this is what it looks like. This is a typical int.hex file. In fact, this is the one that I'm using for one of my demonstrations. So one line contains a byte count, a start address, some type, and then info or data and a checksum. And the control pic will use one line, and after it has read this one line, it will program that one line into the application pic. And at the end, there's an end of file record. So let's go for the demonstration. What I will show here is a blinker LED program using the yellow LED on the YALPIC1 board. Then I will demonstrate that you can send data from via the UART of the application pic to the computer. And you can also send data from the computer to the application pic. So the program will be compiled and downloaded into the YALPIC1 board. And for that I'm using a YAL integrated development environment. So let's go to the demo. I'm now going to demonstrate the blinker LED program. So I have a small program which works as follows. I first need to include a device file which is called the YALPIC1. This is the same as when you select an Arduino board, a certain type of Arduino Uno or another board. Then I make all the pins digital I/O. And as you have seen in the schematic diagram, there is one LED on the board that you can use for testing, and it's connected to pin A0. So I make this pin output, and then I come into this forever loop, starting with switching the LED off, then waiting some time, switching it on again, waiting some time, and then loop back. Now if I want this program to run on the board, I need to compile it first and then program it. So I can use the compile option, I can use the compile and program option, or I can program, but of course I first need to compile it. So I'm using the second one to compile it and program it on the board. And as you can see, the LED is blinking. I also explained that you can send commands to the board. For example, if I want to erase the flash, I could do it by connecting to this board, which is on COM6, and typing the erase flash command. And as you can see, the LED stops blinking and the board returns a zero, which means that everything is okay. In the second demonstration, I'm going to demonstrate how you can send data to the board and get it back via the serial interface and using the terminal mode from the YALPIC1 board. So I start with including the device file. Then I need to define the pins that I'm using for the serial interface and set the baud rate. Then I will include some libraries, for example, serial library, which makes the interfacing easy. Then I define some variables, the pins, and then I need to initialize the serial library. And then the main loop starts, which does the following. As soon as a character is received, it will send the character back to the PC. And once every 5 seconds, it will toggle the LED on the board and it will print a string. I'm going to compile and download the program. It may take some time because I'm also capturing this recording, so that's the compile time will be a little bit longer. But as you see, the yellow LED will be on and off every 5 seconds. And if I now connect to the board and I activate the terminal mode, Then I get a 0 back, which means the command is accepted, and the message from the JALPEG 1 board is sent back to the PC. And I can also send text to the board, which will be echoed back to the PC. So you see, the message being typed will be echoed back, and in the meantime the other message will also be transmitted every 5 seconds. If you want to know more about YAL and the YAL programming language, visit our website. And if you have questions on how to use YAL, you can visit the YAL is Google group. If you find bugs or maybe you're missing a certain library, you can visit the YALLib Google group. And all sources can be found on GitHub. And for the YALPIC 1 board, this is available as a project in the YALLib release. And there you can find all information to make the board yourself and how to use it. I hope you liked this demonstration, and thanks for watching.